हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू चैनल। आई एम आशीष एंड दिस वीडियो आई विल टीच यू अबाउट द टॉपिक ऑफ रोटेटर कफ। रोटेटर कफ यूजुअली आस्क्ड इन शॉर्ट नोट्स, सो वी हैव टू नॉट डिस्कस मच, सो इट्स वेरी इजी टॉपिक टू अंडरस्टैंड। सो लेट अस स्टार्टेड। सो फॉर टुडे, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट मी टेल यू अबाउट द मीनिंग ऑफ द कफ। सो कफ इज एनी स्ट्रक्चर लाइक द स्लीव ऑफ ए शर्ट और स्लीव ऑफ जैकेट विच कवर्स द रिस्ट। सो स्ट्रक्चर्स डेट कवर्स द रिस्ट आर कॉल्ड द कफ, बट द टॉपिक इज रोटेटर कफ। So rotator cuff refers to structures that form around the shoulder joint that aids in the strength of the shoulder joint. As you know, the glenoid labrum helps in the widening of the glenoid cavity, which is very shallow, and the head of the, to fit the huge head of the humerus. Okay, so rotator cuff aids in the stabilization of the shoulder joint. Just we have to remember the four muscles and the four points in case of rotator cuff. So first of all, let's see in 3D where it is located, then we will discuss in the detail about the different muscles and the four points you have to remember in this regard. This 3D illustration will help you to easily visualize the different muscles of the rotator cuff. First of all, let's consider the left shoulder joint and see the different ligaments of the shoulder joint. So here you can see the highlighted portion is the capsule of the shoulder joint to which the different tendons of muscles are attached. These are some other ligaments of the shoulder joint, but they are not of concern for the study. Now let's see the different muscles of the rotator cuff. So this is the fibrous capsule to which the different muscles will be attached. So you can see that it's extend all around the shoulder joint. Now let's concentrate on the right pectoral region and look at the different muscles of the rotator cuff. First one anteriorly is the subscapularis. Next one in the supraspinatus fossa is the supraspinatus muscle, then is the infraspinatus muscle, and then in the last we have the teres minor muscle. So these together form the sits muscle of the rotator cuff. You should always write sits in small letter because it will help you to remember the teres minor muscle. Okay, so you can see how these all the tendons of all the muscles are fused with each other as well as the fibrous capsule to form the rotator cuff, and you are looking across section from this. If you remove all these muscles, you can see the shoulder joint with the glenoid labrum, the glenoid cavity, and the head of the humerus. This is the view from the posterior side. So it helps in the stabilization of the shoulder joint.
I hope the 3D view gave quite a good orientation of the rotator cuff and its muscles. So the very easy trick or mnemonic to remember the rotator cuff muscle is SITS, SITS. Okay, be always sure to write SITS in small letter. Why? Because the teres minor muscle is involved in it. So you will never get confused if you write SIT in small letters. So rotator cuff is the name given to the tendons of the muscle you saw in the back, in the upper part, in the supraspinatus fossa was supraspinatus, in the infraspinatus fossa was infraspinatus, then in the lower portion it was teres minor. That's why we are writing it in small letter. And the anterior and the, or the ventral side on the costal surface of scapula, the muscle was the subscapularis. So these four muscles are fused with the capsule of the shoulder joint. So what is the capsule? Capsule is like a ligamental fiber structure that covers a joint. So okay, so shoulder joint is covered by capsule. So these all four muscles are fused with the capsule of the glenohumeral joint, which is also called the shoulder joint. So another name for shoulder joint is glenohumeral joint. So this was the very first point that you should remember, how the rotator cuff is formed. So it is nothing but a fused tendons of the supraspinatus, infraspinatus, teres minor, and the subscapularis. So to whom it is they are fused? They are fused with the underlying capsule of glenohumeral joint. So this is the capsule of the shoulder joint, and these muscles are fused. So this is the anterior side, this is the posterior side, this is superior, and this is inferior, as you saw in the 3D. So subscapularis in the anterior side. The second point to remember is that tendon of supraspinatus fused superiorly, as you can see in the diagram. The tendon of supraspinatus is fused with the fibrous capsule superiorly. The infraspinatus and teres minor posteriorly and somewhat inferior. And the in the front or the anteriorly we have the subscapularis muscle. So these two points I think it's very clear. Now let's move on to the third and fourth point, which tells us about the importance of the rotator cuff. So rotator cuff plays an important role in the stabilizing the shoulder joint. Why? As you know, the huge head of the humerus has to fit into a very small cavity or the glenoid cavity. Okay, so in order to aid in the stability, this all acts as a cushion to support the joint and the leg as well as the strong stabilizing supports. So this cuff plays an important role in the stabilizing the shoulder joint. So the primary function of the rotator cuff muscle is to grasp the relative large head of humerus and hold it against the shallow glenoid cavity. All these points are adapted from the Visham Singh. You can check it out in that. So these four points are just enough to describe about the rotator cuff. So the clinical importance is that it helps in the holding the head of the humerus against the shallow glenoid cavity. And one more clinical point you can add is that sometimes there is a tear of this rotator cuff. So when it happens, when you fall on the outstretched hand or some days sudden jerk or force on your shoulder joint, then this muscles can or this rotator cuff can tear, the few tendons of this muscles can tear, which will lead to the instability of the shoulder joint or lead to the dislocation of the head of the humerus. So this was all about the rotator cuff. If you like the video, please hit the like button and do subscribe and share your channel. And remember, yes, always write the sits in small letter. Thanks for watching.